Assalamu alaikum. Hi my dear students, welcome back to our English class. Today I am going to teach you grammar. What is the topic? Is transitive verb and intransitive verb. Already I taught you, isn't it? What is the definition and some examples also we have seen that. Did you watch the video? Please watch the video, don't miss the video, because grammar is very, very important. You should watch the video regularly and ask your doubt. As soon as you are seeing the video, if you have any doubt, means sometimes we will forget to ask that. Take one notebook, what are the doubts you have, you can write that, and when you are calling you can ask the doubts. Okay, so here now we are going to learn about what is transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. Already I taught you that definition, isn't it? What is the definition for that? Verbs that take objects are called transitive verbs. Okay, so in a sentence you have subject, verb and object. Okay, the subject will pass on to the object, means we call it as a transitive verbs. Okay, the verbs do not take objects. Verbs that do not take objects are called intransitive verbs. Okay, some words does not take the object, that we called it as a intransitive verbs. The verbs will not pass on to the object. So last class we have seen that examples. The dog chased the cat. The shop is sending as a replacement. Tisha sold some books. These are all examples of transitive verbs. And intransitive verbs: I slept on the couch. Ali fell down the stairs. These are the intransitive verbs. Now we are going to see some exercises. Okay, underline the page number 45. Underline the verbs in the following sentences and state whether they are transitive or intransitive. Circle the objects if the verbs are transitive. So okay, so here we have to say whether it is transitive verb or intransitive verb. First one, A. Sunil passed. Sunil passed the exam. So you have to underline the verbs, isn't it? Which is in the sentence? Which is verb? Verb is the past. And then you have to circle the object if it is transitive. Transitive means you have to circle. Transitive verbs only have the object. Okay, so if it the sentence has object, means you have to circle. Your exam is a object. So here this one is transitive verb. Did you understand? So there are so many examples in your textbook. I am teaching you a few things only. You have to go and see that very easy only, and do that exercise by yourself. So here Sunil passed the exam. So Sunil passed is the, here subject is Sunil, pass is the verb, you know. So we have to underline the verb and you have to circle the object, exam. So in this sentence you understand that the verb takes the object. The verb takes the object. That means we call it as a transitive verb. Okay, so here the verb is also there, object is there. So the verb is pausing to the object, we call it as a transitive verb. And then next one. B. The dog was barking loudly. So here barking, you know, verb. Barking means verb. The dog barking loudly. Can this verb is takes the object? No. Okay, it's one loudly is the how it barks only tells. It not pausing any object here. So we call this sentence as intransitive verb. In transitive verb. So what I told you, the verb should take the object, we called it as a, what is it, transitive verb. Here in the sentence, how the dog is barks, only they are saying the statement, it doesn't take the object. So the dog was barking loudly is an intransitive verb. It doesn't take the object. Okay. If there is no objects, means you have to say it as an intransitive verb. Next one. C. She called her mother early in the morning. Early in the morning. So here called is the verb. And called is the verb. And then mother is the object. So the verb takes the object, pausing to the what is that object. She called her mother. Okay, so it takes the object. So here called is the verb, mother is the what is that object. So what is, if you in a sentence if you have that object, means what I told you, it's a transitive verb. Transitive verb. And then I saw the children playing tennis. Okay, I saw the children playing tennis. A, B, C, D. I saw the children playing tennis. So here, what is that? Playing is a, what is that? Verb. Isn't it? I saw the children playing tennis. Tennis is the, what is that? Object. Okay. So it's a pausing to the object. So we call it as transitive verb. And then two more examples we are going to see. Did you understand? So I saw the children playing is the verb. Playing is the verb. So it's pausing the two tennis. What they are playing? Tennis. So tennis is the object. So the Indian sentence as object means we call it as a transitive verb. And then so don't want to worry, I will send you that every exercise through WhatsApp. She studied. Archaeology. She studied archaeology. So here studied is the verb and archaeology is the what is it? Object. What she studied. So it's pausing to the object. So it's called it as a transitive verb. And then next one. This is E. This is F. She slept. She slept for 12 hours. So here slept is the verb, but it doesn't take the object. Okay, it tells the statement only. She slept for 12 hours. That's all. So this one is intransitive verb. This one is intransitive verb. And then I don't drink coffee. Some of the exercise you have to try and do that. Okay, I'm not writing everything, you just try it. Understand? I don't drink coffee. I don't drink coffee. So drink is a what is that? Verb and coffee is a object. So it pausing to the object. So that sentence we call it as a transitive verb. Did you understand? I don't drink coffee. Drink is the verb. So it takes the object. Okay. What didn't drink. I don't drink coffee. So here drink is the verb. Coffee is the object. And in a sentence if you have the object, we call it as a transitive verb. And then one more intransitive verb, we will see that. Okay, I'm not writing in the order, some of the examples only I'm teaching, so don't see that what is it, alphabetical letters. H. The shop was closed. The shop was closed. Here, what is it? Closed is the verb, but it doesn't take the object. Okay, closed is the verb. The shop was closed. It gives a statement, but it's not taking any object. So that sentence we call it as an intransitive verb. Intransitive verb. And then one more example, we can see that Shalini took the puppy. Shalini took the puppy out for a walk. So took is a verb, and what is it here? Object puppy. Okay, puppy is the object. So you have to round that. So Shalini took the puppy out for a walk. Took is the verb, and it takes the object puppy. So this sentence we called it as a transitive verb. So understand. So there are remaining examples. You just try that. If you have any doubt, you can call me. Okay. So we have seen so many examples of transitive verb and intransitive verb. Okay. So what I told you, in a sentence, transitive verb, it takes the verb and object. Okay, it will pause on to object. That sentence we call it as a transitive verb. Intransitive verb, in that sentence it doesn't take the object. Okay, it won't pause that. Okay, it just tell the statement. Understand? So we have seen that examples of transitive verb and intransitive verb. It's very very important in grammar chapter. So I think you are all understand this chapter. So next class we will start a new chapter from grammar. Keep watching that video. Don't skip any videos. Don't miss the video. It will be useful for your lifetime. Okay, English is very very important. So when you are going to 7th standard, 8th standard, the basic is very very important. What is a verb? What is a noun? What is an adjective? So everything you should know about the basic. Then if you want to talk or if you want to write the English correctly, everything will be comes correctly. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can ask me through mobile. Until then, take care. Assalamu alaikum.